In this video, you will begin to code your first SQL statements. For this purpose, we use the code editor to enter and execute those statements. The very first thing you need to do is to choose and select a database. Because a server usually contains many databases, you must let MySQL know which one of those you're going to communicate with. The use statement is the one you're going to need for this purpose, and it's the very first statement you're going to learn. Let's code our first example. Let's execute this statement. This particular use statement tells MySQL to use the GoLearnFast database as the current database for the subsequent statements. You call this statement with the use keyword followed by the database's name. Note that MySQL always requires a semicolon at the end of each single statement. If you look down here, the output window shows a green light. This means that your statement was executed correctly. Let's see what happens if you make a mistake. Obviously, the GoLearnFast underscore 3 does not exist. As you can see, you get a red light and an error message. Let's correct it and execute it again. There you go. We have again a green light. The second statement you're going to learn is the select statement, which is used to retrieve data from a base table. Let's choose a table from the GoLearnFast database. This is the name H table of the GoLearnFast database. Let me show you our second example. This code says, "Hey, show me all of the rows of the first name and last name columns from the name H table." You code the select keyword followed by a list of column names separated by commas. This is called the select clause. Then you code the from keyword followed by the name of the base table from which the query retrieves the data. This is called the from clause. Let's execute it. So, when you execute the statement, the listed columns are retrieved from the base table, named in the from clause, and stored in a result set. A result set is a table of data resulted from a statement. You can think of it as a temporary table that's created within a database. Note that when you execute a use statement alone, you do not get any results back, because a use statement itself does not expect to have any results back. Of course, you can retrieve all of the rows and columns from a table, and not only two of them. This statement retrieves the first name, the last name, and the age columns from the name age table. Let me show you a shorthand for this statement. Let's make a little change at the code. In the select clause, you can code an asterisk as a shorthand to indicate that all of the rows and columns should be retrieved. As a result, those two statements are identical. Let's have a look at the CDs table. Let's say you want to retrieve the state and capital columns from this table. As you can see, this select statement retrieves the state and capital columns from the CDs table. Let's compare this result set with the CDs table. As you can see, by default, all of the rows in the base table are included in the result set. In some cases, that means that the result set will contain duplicate rows or rows whose column values are identical. In this result set, for example, you can see that California, Sacramento occurs 3 times. If that's not what you want, you can include the distinct keyword in the select clause to eliminate the duplicate rows. Let's see how. The distinct keyword prevents duplicate rows from being included in the result set. Let's compare this result set with the previous one. This select statement retrieves the state and capital columns from the cities table and eliminates duplicate rows. It includes the distinct keyword, so each state and capital combination is included only once. Note that distinct row is a synonym for distinct, so these two statements are the same. Let's have a look at this other select statement. As you can see, this select clause includes the all keyword. It causes all rows matching the search condition to be included in the result set, regardless of whether rows are duplicated. The all keyword is a default and can therefore be omitted. Because of that, those two statements are the same. Before you execute a SQL statement, make sure you have selected a database. If we cancel this use statement, for instance, we'll get an error message. If you haven't selected the correct database before you execute a SQL statement, you'll get an error message. For example, if you select the GolemFast2 database and attempt to retrieve data from the NameAge table, which is contained in the GolemFast database and not in the GolemFast2 database, you'll get an error message. When you code a use statement, the selected database remains selected until you issue a new use statement. Let's insert a new use statement. This use statement tells MySQL to select the GoLearnFast2 database as the current database. So, if you attempt to retrieve data from the name each table again, you'll get an error message. Note that this result set refers to the first select statement. Note that MySQL always requires a semicolon at the end of each single statement. If you forget it, you'll get an error message. SQL is a free-form language. That means that you can include line breaks, spaces, and indentation without affecting the way the database interprets the code. Therefore, this statement is perfectly working. However, it's recommended to keep your code clean and well structured. SQL is not case sensitive. That means that you can use uppercase or lowercase letters or a combination of the two without affecting the way the database interprets the code. Therefore, this statement is perfectly working. However, it's recommended to follow some simple coding guidelines. Capitalize all keywords, use lowercase for the other code, and start each clause on a new line.